Hi everybody, I'm Kirsty Meekie and welcome to the Naio Nails channel. This is our like Halloween edition, clearly, because I've got the Halloween makeup on. So, I'm going to show you a design today that's going to be, it's going to be simple, but it's quite cool. I think it's cool anyway, clearly, because I've come up with it and yeah, I like it. So, I've got a rounded off nail here. So this is the kind of shape that I think this works with. You could use other shapes, but I just think it works well with more of a round almond kind of shaped nail. So what I'm gonna do is, I'm just gonna buff over this nail. Gonna use the new buffer, which is 100 grit and 180. We're gonna use 100 grit side just to abrase that top surface, just like if it was a natural nail and you'd need to abrase that surface before applying your gel polish. Now, because this isn't a natural nail, I don't need to put the base coat on, but if this was a natural nail, please put the Urban Graffiti base coat on. And I am going to start with Serious Black, the most appropriate colour for Halloween, and I'm going to do two coats of the black. So Serious Black. You want to make sure these are really thin coats of black. It is really pigmented. Look what's come out. I've got the magnets out. The cat eyes magnets. Look, try to push them together. Why do I find magnets so much fun?
Oh, they're new magnets.
Yeah, they're new ones, eh? So, because the magnets are out, we're obviously going to use the cat eyes formula. So this is the gel polish from Urban Graffiti. And it's a gorgeous colour. It's called Mulled Wine. Always looks best over the top of black. That's why I've done black. See, it's all making sense now. And we're going to do a nice thin layer of mulled wine over the top of the black. And what I'm going to do is, just place that down a second, I'm going to get the magnets, the new magnets have got the round ends on as well. And I'm going to get both of those and I'm going to push the product at these ends to create that gorgeous little pattern. Let me go again. You want to push the magnet particles in the polish into the shape you want, and that's what I want. Let's get it in the lamp. So by using both of the round ends and pushing this way, and they kind of don't want to push together either, so I found like as soon as I got close like that, they were pushing away from each other. So you want to hold them in the position and kind of push the particles in the gel polish to create this kind of, you get like a little swirl. I will show you again in a moment. I wanted to cure it pretty quickly just so it really holds that shape. It's a little bit easier when you're doing it on a client than it is doing it on a tip, to be honest, because the client will just hold their finger there for you and then you can work the magnets to create the shape that you want. Let's have a little look. So can you see how we've got this like cool kind of swirl? Let me just zoom in a little bit for you.
Kind of looks like smart.
It looks like what?
Smoke.
Like smoke?
Yes.
Smoke? Looks like smoke. So Jay says.
Smoke.
Smoke. Smoke, duck. It looks a bit smoky. It does, yeah. It's cool, isn't it? So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to put matte top coat over the top of this. Just for a different effect. You could put shiny, but I'm just going for matte at the minute. But you know I do like to change my mind. And pop that into a lamp. Then you're going to need Snow White. Now this is for our ghost. Our ghost is not no normal ghost. I mean, our ghost normal? No. I don't think they are normal, are they, Jay?
Nah.
Nah, they're not normal. Alright, so what we want to do with our little ghost is we want to make these kind of tail ends look a little bit like flames, and that's what's going to make our ghost look a little bit different, you know, a little bit different than the average ghost. So we're going to come round the top of here and we can fill this shape in now. I'm going to put that in the lamp and cure, and then I'm going to do a second layer of colour of the white. Yes, I'm going to go directly over the top now. I can use the brush from the bottle for that part, but the other parts I want to use that same liner brush. So that's our second coat of the white. You can see it's so much more opaque now as well. Now at the minute it just looks like a white flame, but it's not, is it? We know it's going to be a ghost. And what's going to make it a ghost? Well, it needs two eyes and a mouth. So we're going to use Serious Black to do the eyes and mouth. So we can use a dotting tool to do the eyes. And then we want a mouth. A scary mouth.
Ooh. Little Pac-Man ghosts broke out the game.
And then what I'm going to do is I'm going to add a little bit of shadow. And all I'm going to do with this is just shadow little parts. You don't have to do it all. Little parts of the ghost. So where the white meets that cat's eye. It'll just make it stand out a little bit more. I'm keeping all my shadows on one side. Let's pop that in the lamp. And then with the extra bit of white that we've got, we're going to use that and we're going to do like a baby ghost. And they kind of look like little tadpoles, little worms, not worms, sperms. And let's do their eyes. And their scary mouth. And then we'll add that little bit of shadowing like we did before on the big one. That in. Now, do we shiny top coat the ghost or do we matte top coat the whole thing?
I am partial to mixing the two together.
Are you a bit partial to that? Shall we do that then?
Do like that, yeah.
Right, let's get the Urban Graffiti top coat. This has no sticky layer. I can use the brush on that part, but I will need to use a smaller brush to go over the top of. So I need a smaller brush to go over the top of the little goose. Secure that. I'm going to go over the top of our little baby ghosts. These are baby ghosts in training.
Now, do adult ghosts have baby ghosts, or where do baby ghosts come from?
Today they have the baby ghosts. Okay. I don't know how they make the baby ghosts. I don't know if I want to know how they make the baby ghosts. So there we are. Got the ghosts flying up the nail. So as you wear it, you would wear it like this. And then as you hold your hand up, you'll be like, hey, you like my ghosts? And I love the background, how you've got that cat eye effect in the background. I think it makes it a little bit more spooky.
Yeah, very nice.
But they also look like flames as well, properly. So they're kind of cool all at the same time, do you know what I mean? Sorry, Jay, what were you saying?
I was saying, for like, if you're doing like a set out of them, you'd just use like different cat's eyes colours underneath them, wouldn't you? Maybe like blues and purples as well.
Yeah, you can do whatever colour cat eye you want in the background. You could really play with that. But I love that little technique with the, you know, with the magnets, that's like, yeah. It's so cool going, and it just pushes it, into shape. You know what I mean, when you go, cool, I like it. There you are, guys. Another Halloween design. This is a quick, easy one, easy to do in the salon. Give it a go. Don't forget to hashtag us and check us out on Facebook and Instagram. Everything I've used today will be listed below. And I'll see you in the next video. Bye-bye.